fire official could lose his job over what happened in the Aerotech explosion. Smoke and flames billowed into the sky that October evening. Tonight on Channel 8 Eyewitness News Live at 6, George Knapp has an exclusive interview with a county commissioner who wants heads to roll.
Two of the most powerful men in the war on terrorism visit Southern Nevada. We'll have team coverage of the visits of Tom Ridge and Don Rumsfeld.
This is your worst nightmare. And then, I mean, actually getting them back, I mean, what are the chances?
And a family celebrates the safe return of their missing relative. We'll hear from them and the missing man himself.
Also, they look like they're tasting fine wine, but they're actually checking out the taste of the valley's drinking water. You'll meet them in a special report.
You're watching Channel 8 Eyewitness News at 6 with Paula Francis, Gary Waddell, Neighborhood Weather with Kevin Janison, and Sports with Dave McCann. Channel 8 Eyewitness News, the news leader.
Flames and explosions ripped through the Aerotech rocket plant back in October, taking one life and causing millions of dollars in damage. Good evening. Thanks for joining us.
4 months later, that fire is generating a different kind of heat. At least one county commissioner wants the county fire chief fired over it.
The Channel 8 I-Team's George Knapp is here with the exclusive story. George.
Paul and Gary, since the county fire department issued its supposedly comprehensive report on the Aerotech fire a few weeks ago, questions have continued to mount, both about the report and about fire department honchos, in particular about Chief Earl Green. Now, County Commissioner Erin Kenney is saying it may be time for Green to go, and she isn't alone. Sparks continue to be generated by last October's fire that consumed several businesses, including the Aerotech rocket operation. As we've reported, a 90-page report on the incident left some gaping holes, such as what caused a drum of magnesium to explode, and why did the fire department fail to inspect Aerotech for 5 straight years, even though hundreds of pounds of highly flammable chemicals were routinely stored there. Fire Chief Earl Green has been largely unavailable to answer our questions since the report was issued. For Green's critics, the Aerotech matter may be the final straw.
I think that perhaps it's time to make a change at the top of the ladder in the fire department.
County Commissioner Erin Kenney says she considers herself a friend of Earl Green's, but says she's had a steady stream of complaints about his job performance. Kenney says she's disturbed about a lack of inspections at Aerotech and elsewhere because of what it means to public safety and to the safety of firefighters.
We've got the best firefighters in the country. I believe that with my heart of hearts. But we need to make sure that we're also providing the absolute best public safety available. I know that there has been discussions about this, but I think that when you have a series of situations where you've got firefighters who aren't happy, you've got things like Aerotech coming up, I think it's time at least to reflect and see if it's not time to look at the situation and see if a change needs to be made.
County Commissioner Dario Herrera echoed those sentiments, telling us he too has been swamped with grievances and issues about Chief Green. Herrera says he's concluded that Green isn't fit to hold the job. However, County Manager Tom Riley, the guy who does the hiring and firing, says he's carefully reviewed all issues raised about Green and at this point sees no reason to make a change. As for the Aerotech matter, Riley says he's going to wait until the state fire marshal has finished a review of the case. Kenny and Herrera are both careful to say they are not criticizing firefighters. Rather, it's the firefighters who are complaining to them about equipment needs, training standards, and grievances, including workers' comp issues, and how such matters have been handled by the chief.
The administration is a separate group. And there's guys on the line and guys not on the line.
We haven't yet had a chance to ask Chief Green about these matters on camera, but he did talk to us by phone late this afternoon. He said he wants a chance to sit down and talk to Commissioner Kenney about her concerns before he comments, but said his department has been thoroughly checked, scrutinized, and audited, and that it is doing as well as or better than any fire department in the country. Chief Green has agreed to an on-camera interview later this week, and of course we'll keep you posted what he has to say.
It's probably the tip of the iceberg, right? What's happening under the water?
Well, I mean, politically, there's a lot of stuff going on and on a lot of levels because you figure in this particular media environment, the support of firefighters since 911, that's vital.
Yes.
I mean, to any elected official who wants to get reelected, it's one reason Commissioners Kenney and Herrera are careful to make a distinction between firefighters and the department honchos. And I am told the commission is pretty much split
almost down the middle about Chief Green. He does have his supporters on the county commission, but the commissioners don't hire or fire department heads. Yeah. That's up to the county manager. And without some sort of new information or new issues, Tom Riley says he is inclined to keep Chief Green at this point.
Okay. Thank you, George.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Two of the most important people in the war on terrorism spent today here in southern Nevada. Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld toured Nellis Air Force Base, and Homeland Security Chief Tom Ridge visited the Nevada test site. We start tonight's team coverage with Tom Ridge. Channel 8 Eyewitness News is live. Tom Jones joins us from the Nevada test site. Tom.
Gary, Tom Ridge really believes that Nevada can help put a dent in terrorism, first by expanding the counterterrorism program that goes on out here at the Nevada test site. Ridge also believes the stealth state can help in a way that many opponents of Yucca Mountain might not like.
I don't believe that we should be satisfied today with the level of training to deal with these unconventional terrorist attacks.
That's why Homeland Security Director Tom Ridge accepted Senator Harry Reid's invitation to take a look at the counterterrorism training going on at the Nevada test site. Reid wants to expand the program so that all emergency responders in the country could be trained to combat terrorism here. It would be called the National Center for Combating Terrorism. Ridge liked what he saw.
I don't know what name you would have put on this, but I think the senator's got a pretty good idea here in terms of taking a look at this and expand its capacity so we can help enhance national security.
National security is one reason why Senator Reid and Governor Kenny Gwynn opposed the transportation of 77,000 tons of high-level nuclear waste to Yucca Mountain. But Ridge says he's not concerned about any terrorist attacks on the waste as it's being transported, and he says putting the waste in one place increases security.
There is a homeland security portion of it, i.e., reduce the number of sites of vulnerability within, I think, the 39 or 40 states that have these facilities.
Governor Gwynn and Reid said this wasn't the time to talk about nuclear waste and Yucca Mountain.
I know there have been questions asked about nuclear waste. Listen, we've got a lot to talk about there, and we'll have plenty of time to do it. I will meet with Joe Alba. We will talk about the transportation situation there. I will meet with Governor Ridge to talk about that. But today is not a nuclear waste day.
Ridge says he will work hard to make this National Counterterrorism Training Center at the task site a reality. It'll take about $60 million to make that work. Back to you.
Tom, Governor Ridge didn't talk specifically about Yucca Mountain, but we did hear him talk a little about nuclear waste there and the need to store it in one place. What all did he say about that?
Well, he said that as governor of Pennsylvania, he didn't want the waste in his state, and he realized that there was a need for it all to be in one location. So he said that's why he supports the waste being transported to Yucca Mountain. And he said in 50 years or so, he's never seen an accident, so he supports it. But as you heard Senator Reid say, he will lobby the former governor and the National Security, Homeland Security Director, to try to change his mind on that.
Okay, Senator Reid tried to change the subject pretty quickly there. Thank you very much, Tom.
Yeah.
Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld also stopped in southern Nevada. He went to see the troops at Nellis Air Force Base. Nellis is a key training ground for Air Force pilots. Secretary Rumsfeld watched those pilots at work during red flag exercises. Channel 8 Eyewitness News is live. Lisa Johnson is at Nellis with the story. Lisa.
Paula, Secretary of Defense Donald Rumsfeld arrived here at Nellis early this morning. He was here to brief officials on the latest on the war on terrorism. He began his day with a town hall meeting where he tried to answer the main question on the minds of the military here: how long will we be in Afghanistan?
There's no way to know how long. It is not days, weeks, months. It's years for sure.
After meeting with the airmen and their families, Rumsfeld watched his first red flag exercises. Over 100 Air Force fighter pilots are taking part in this realistic combat exercise.
There's a cliche almost that you need to train the way you fight and fight the way you train. And it is an important thought.
The 21st Secretary of Defense then met with the local media. And just like when he holds his Pentagon briefings, he was a straight shooter. Rumsfeld explained the government will not be giving information to the media, as has been reported recently, but that instead they will not be releasing all military actions.
If we have a group of special forces, for example, that are about to engage in an action someplace, and they're going to go into an Al-Qaeda compound, we would like to have tactical surprise. We would like to have them not know we are coming.
The Secretary of Defense also met with Congresswoman Shelley Berkley while here. She asked him for better military pay and more money for housing out here at Nellis. The Secretary of Defense told her he's working on it. And tonight, he's headed back to Washington, D.C. Lisa Johnson, Channel 8 Eyewitness News Live.
Thank you, Lisa. Here's what's happening today in the war on terrorism. Secretary Rumsfeld met with troops in Salt Lake City this morning before coming here. Rumsfeld defended the Pentagon's plan to increase pro-American sentiment abroad. Rumsfeld refuted reports that the Pentagon is considering sending false news items to foreign media. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff visited troops in Kandahar today. General Richard Myers says American troops aren't helping the Afghan government battle factions there. Myers is on a five-day tour of the region. And in Rome today, police arrested four Moroccans after finding evidence the men may have been plotting an attack on Rome's water supply or on the U.S. Embassy in Rome. Authorities say the men had large amounts of cyanide and maps of Rome pinpointing the U.S. Embassy.
The mentally disabled man who was missing for a week is still hospitalized here in Southern Nevada tonight. 32-year-old Herman Ramos has the mental capacity of an 8-year-old, but he knows he is happy to be reunited with his family. Channel 8 Eyewitness News is live. Cindy Caesar is at UMC where Ramos is being treated. Cindy.
Well, Ramos is still here at UMC because he did suffer some kidney damage from his dehydration over the last week. His family thinks he was walking around Northwest Las Vegas for an entire week.
Chicken patas.
You want chicken patas? Chicken patas is chicken legs.
A special food request and some family hugs is what 32-year-old Herman Ramos wanted after a week of being lost.
You know what, I'm not sure what he ate. He keeps saying it was a poison because it made him throw up.
His family and police detectives are still trying to figure out what the mentally disabled man did for an entire week on his own. He left his Northwest Las Vegas home on Tuesday to do his 8-year daily ritual of watering his relatives' plants a couple of blocks away. But when his uncle told him to go back home, his family thinks he got confused and walked away.
Works like an 8 to 10-year-old, so if you don't mind taking a car and calling one of these numbers?
Yeah. Dozens of family members searched Northwest Las Vegas, but as the days went by, they began to lose hope.
And I seen him, I was like, hey, Herman, here's your Pepsi. I just bought a big bottle.
Family members were ecstatic when Ramos was found by some neighborhood teens just a couple of blocks away from his home on Tuesday. He was so exhausted, hungry, and dehydrated that his family thinks he just walked around for an entire week.
He just starts blurting out certain things after a while, you know. So I'd say maybe a couple of days or something, and he'll start coming out with things, you know, and then try piecing it together.
Police detectives did speak with Herman Ramos here at the hospital yesterday, and according to the family, they do not believe that he was harmed in any way by any person while he was missing for that entire week. Ramos is hoping to leave here at the hospital tomorrow, and he's especially looking forward to a big block party being planned for Saturday afternoon. Cindy Caesar, Channel 8 Eyewitness News, live.
I hope he gets well soon. It's nice to have him back. Thanks, Cindy.
A Las Vegas family that was doing fine 1 month ago is now struggling to get by because of crushing health problems.
Coming up tonight at 6:30, we'll have one of the most heart-wrenching stories you'll ever hear. Andrea Bond joins us now with a preview.
Well, the story we'll share with you is that of the Everett family. They are the typical American couple trying to live the American dream, but now they are facing a crisis, and since September 11th, a bad situation has gotten even worse.
It's very frustrating. I mean, it's just, I can't say how frustrating it is.
Coming up tonight at 6:30, we will tell you why their story is so devastating and how their dilemma could happen to any one of us. It really is a story that you'll want to stay tuned for, and it's something you'll see only here on Channel 8 Eyewitness News.
So it's an important story for people to see.
For everyone.
Thanks, Andrea. Sure. We'll see you in a minute.
Okay.
Southern Nevada water has a bad reputation, but does it deserve it? We'll meet the people who monitor the taste that comes from your tap.
Eyes are the windows of the soul. Could they also protect you from stroke? See how in tonight's Channel 8 Medical Breakthroughs.
Later in this hour, we'll show you if there's enough vaccine to keep your children safe from illness.
But first, Kevin joins us live from Darnell Elementary with a first look at the weather. Kevin.
All right, Gary and Paula, we're very excited to introduce our latest addition to the Neighborhood Weather Network. We'll be showing you the conditions out here, have the full forecast coming up in a couple of minutes. But first, we have Ashley. How you doing?
Good.
Smile. What happened to the teeth? We're missing some teeth out here. The forecast is coming up in just a few minutes. You got a smile. Let me see that smile.
This portion of Eyewitness News is brought to you by American Family Insurance.
Locals will love us a lot.
And it's another great place to use your boarding pass.
My side of town. Hello.
It's got great restaurants and bars.
I'm playing the penny slots.
The parking is excellent.
This is a place where anybody can just feel, you know, at home.
This will be the only place I come to.
Don't miss it.
I love this place. The people are nice, and I'll be back many times.
Stand by. There we go.
Clear. We are go for digital installation.
Systems check.
Order digital cable now.
Green light.
And get 6 free channels of Starz. Plus 10 free channels of HBO. 16 premium movie channels. Absolutely free.
Ready? Go! It's all now.
We have installation.
It's the grand opening of Cal's Boat and RV, the biggest boat and RV superstore in the state. We're located at Russell Road and the US 95 Freeway. During this sale, you can save on the entire line of Four Winds and Chaparral deck boats, runabouts, cuddies and cruisers, Sierra, Salem and Jayco toy haulers, travel trailers and fifth wheels. Even Arctic Cat ATVs are on sale. Make Cal's your one-stop recreation destination for quality boats and RVs.
Come and see my grandpa's big toy store.
Cal's Boat and RV.
Used car buyers, used truck buyers, SUV buyers, Nevada Dodge, 1 week only. They're guaranteeing you $3,000 minimum for any trade-in. And exclusive of that, $3,000 now cash or trade-in. You can buy this 2001 model Ram 1500 truck, $8,988. Or a 1999 Mazda 626, $7,988. Nevada Dodge, perhaps the largest used car inventory in Las Vegas. But the deadline's Monday night. Nevada Dodge.
This portion of Eyewitness News is brought to you by the Rio Suite Hotel Casino.
Most of Southern Nevada's water comes from Lake Mead, and while it's perfectly safe to drink, about two-thirds of Valley residents drink bottled water or use reverse osmosis systems at home. Tonight, in my special report, I'll introduce you to a team of tasters dedicated to drinking water straight from the tap.
From sniffing to sampling, professional tasting is a matter of technique.
The nose is the key.
And proper description.
Metallic.
Chlorine. Astringent.
But these tasters don't work for a fancy strip restaurant. Their employer is the Southern Nevada Water Authority.
And we have a very high quality water supply. The flavor profile and our other testing is to ensure that the consumer gets a consistent product.
Picked for their palates, flavor profiling is a part-time assignment at the utility. Chemists like Rebecca Colgate are trained in food industry methods to detect changes in the smell and flavor of Las Vegas tap water.
There are some things that we learned we can smell and taste in parts per trillion.
The process starts with a sip of bottled spring water.
We use that to clean our palate and use it as a comparison.
Ratings are based on a scale of 0 to 3.
Chlorine 1.5.
Tasters meet 3 times a week to sample water from a handful of the hundreds of distribution sites in the valley. Almost 90% of the valley's water flows from Lake Mead. At times, Tasters pick up changes in the water before lab equipment does, especially during seasonal algae blooms on the lake.
Our treatment people then have gotten to the point where when we tell them, okay, the lake is turning over, they believe us.
But learning the proprieties of tasting comes with a price, $200,000, since the program started in 1999.
The training is expensive, but, you know, we have a lot of instruments that cost more than this training does.
Testing also helps address some complaints consumers have about the water.
Probably the most common complaint is chlorine. They don't like the particular taste of the chlorine.
One thing the training proves is some palates are more sensitive than others.
Now that I'm trained and I taste this all the time, I know it can have different flavors.
Metallic it has.
Officials say concerns about the area's drinking water are a matter of perception, not safety. Most differences tasters report are subtle at best.
We wouldn't be tasting the water if we thought there was a health hazard to it.
But when pressed, even professionals have their preferences.
I can't say, but my preferences are the well water in the Northwest and the north of Las Vegas area, but that's personal preference.
Water Authority says the taste of water may vary around the valley because of differences in chlorine levels, but they say the levels are never unhealthy. Leaving some tap water in the refrigerator overnight will improve the taste because the chlorine will dissipate. KLASTV.com has a direct link to the Water Authority's website. You'll find tips there for buying water filters and water softeners.
Imagine a test that could reliably predict a stroke. Such a predictor would save thousands of people from paralysis and even death. One day soon, it may be possible, as we see in tonight's medical breakthroughs.
That's perfect. There'll be a flash. Hold still. That's good.
Typically, a routine eye exam looks at the health of your eyes.
Good.
One day, it may be able to tell you something about the health of your body, specifically your risk of stroke.
My role here was to essentially look at the eye changes and seeing whether that tell us something about, whether or not our cardiovascular health itself.
Ophthalmologist Tian Wong is on a hunt. He's reviewing images of the eyes of 10,000 people.
That we take the film-based photographs, we scan them into a high-resolution digital image, and then we enlarge them into, multiple times their size.
A computer measures the width of blood vessels and compares them to the standard.
At least the early findings in this study shows that even in people who are not considered at higher risk of stroke, including the general healthy middle-aged people, if you have some of these changes, you are, at a higher risk of stroke.
He warns the research is very early. However, he's optimistic it will shed more light on stroke prevention.
You know, it is possible that looking at the eye in the future might, give you a little bit more information than, just measuring your blood pressure or cholesterol.
The computer program that measures the vessels is available only at the University of Wisconsin. The retinal camera is available in most eye clinics. The study itself is taking place around the U.S., but all the images are sent to Dr. Wong's lab for review. If you'd like more information about this, send us a self-addressed stamped envelope. Write Eye Exam Stroke on the front. You can also find a lot of information on our website.
Time now to check on traffic. There's been an accident on I-15 between Flamingo and Spring Mountain Road. Kyla Grogan joins us live from Chopper 8. Kyla.
That's right. I'll tell you, this is the only accident that Nevada Highway Patrol is reporting right now, which is actually great news, and it's a very minor accident. Let's take a look. It's I-15 northbound, as you mentioned, between Spring Mountain and Flamingo. You can see they have cleared things off to the left-hand side, and boy, look at the traffic. We're doing really great tonight. We just checked all our trouble spots. US 95 is looking great. Spaghetti Bowl is looking great. So I guess the verdict for this evening is that it's a very safe ride home and probably a quicker ride home than you're used to. So good news. Reporting from Chopper 8, Kyla Gergen, Channel 8 Eyewitness News Live.
All right, Kyla, thank you very much.
Well, our weatherman is on a mission to put a weather station in just about every elementary school in the valley.
Well, I tell you, on a day like today, I wouldn't stay in the studio if I didn't have to either.
No, what a beautiful day.
Right, Kevin?
Absolutely. It's nice to come outside. A gorgeous evening in progress as well, Paula and Gary. We are at Darnell Elementary, site of one of our newest neighborhood weather stations, along with Jeff Frainer, with the Frainer family businesses. You guys do a lot of good stuff up here.
Thank you.
Well, what I mean, you've built half the town up here, haven't you?
We try.
You do a good job. Well, if it wasn't for sponsors like you, we would not be able to put weather stations up here. So thank you very much. We have met before. You've also helped out with the City of Hope. Why do you get involved in so many community activities like this?
It's just a chance to get back and help others that's helped us.
Right. I'm sorry?
It just to help us throughout the years to help give back to them.
Well, you do a great job, and you've got this young man here too, right?
That's my son, Dylan.
All right, Dylan, how can I get my hair to do this?
Get gel.
Gel. And lots of it, right? All right, Dylan, thank you very much. We have over here assembled our helpers to bring us the weather live from Darnell Elementary. We have Sarah, Jamie, and Taylor. Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Good. Here we go. Real-time neighborhood weather from Darnell Elementary. There you go.
57 degrees.
High is 70s and low is 43.
Fine job. Please have your agent call the station tomorrow. Let's move across town now. We'll go down to Eastern and the St. Rose Parkway. You guys really did a good job. 62 down there. Elsewhere, we'll move over to Jones and Smoke Ranch where it's 58. And one more stop will take us up to Child Haven near Bonanza and Pecos. They are at 61 degrees. Other neighborhood temperatures range from 60 degrees in Summerlin. It's still 68 near Cary and Hollywood. Outside the valley, 44 on the mountain, 45 in PO. It's still 75 in Death Valley. How about the highs today? Anywhere from the upper 60s to the mid 70s, 75 near Windmill and Paradise. Outside the valley, 56 on the mountain, 80 in Prim and Death Valley, 83 in Laughlin. At McCarran, the top temperature was 69, 64 would be normal. And around the country, we are looking at snow in Minnesota and Wisconsin, rain showers all along the East Coast. Closer to home, high pressure builds in, and that's going to send all those clouds in the Pacific way north. We should have some beautiful weather and warmer temperatures even still over the next few days. Tonight, clear, looking for a low temperature of 45 degrees. After midnight, there will be a few breezes that pick up. Then tomorrow, we're looking for a high in the 70s with some neighborhoods in the upper 70s. And a look ahead at your seven-day forecast, we could actually set record highs when we get to Friday and especially Saturday, when we expect the high temperature to get up to 79 degrees. We've been working on our weather. They've done these great weather projects out here at Darnell Elementary. I have Andrew. Andrew, how do you convert Fahrenheit to Celsius?
Well, Fahrenheit is 9/5 Celsius plus 32.
How'd you know that? How'd you know that?
Because you told me.
Good job, Andrew. Very nice. He passes the test. All right, wave goodbye to Gary and Paula. We'll see you again in a few minutes.
Thanks, Kevin.
Thank you. Dave McCann is here now with all the sports. And it was a good day for the Americans in Salt Lake City.
They just keep winning up there.
That's amazing.
Big party in Salt Lake. We'll update the Metal Boy and show you just what's going on. Update the hockey team as well. Basketball is what's going on in Reno as the Boys and Girls State tournaments get underway. Scores and highlights from today's first round are just ahead. Also coming up, John Robinson's Rebels will have at least three more chances to play in the Liberty Bowl. I'll tell you why next here on Channel 8.
Neighborhood Weather is brought to you by Lamplight Neighborhoods and your hometown neighborhood builder, Karina Holmes.
Hey, guys.
Never pay for long distance again with Singular Wireless. And right now, get 3,500 night and weekend bonus minutes plus a great deal on a Nokia phone. Nationwide self-expression is Singular.
Get ready to gear up and get out in a legendary Jeep vehicle. The most award-winning brand of 4x4s. And only Jeep gets you there with protection, like a 7-year, 100,000-mile powertrain pledge on engines and transmissions, plus generous cash allowances of up to $2,500 or 0% financing on select vehicles. Great products, great protection, great values. That's the Jeep promise.
See your Southern Nevada Jeep dealer.
There's a place in everyone's imagination where if you believe, anything can happen. FX Alive, starring Rick Springfield. FX like you've never seen it before.
Ashley Furniture Home Store presents Free February. For the remainder of the month of February, buy any five-piece living room and get a pair of lamps free.
Free!
Buy any complete bedroom and get a second nightstand free. Buy any five-piece dining room and get another side chair free. Plus, free financing until February 2003. For factory direct prices, plus free furniture and free financing for one full year. Hurry in today. This event ends the 28th at 7 p.m. You're going to love Free February.
Hi, I'm John Elway for Desert Nissan. Nobody beats our prices.
It's a done deal. The all-new Desert Nissan Altima or Frontier, now $17,444 out the door. Through Saturday, Desert Nissan has set the price on the 2002 Altima or Frontier Crew Cab XE at just $17,444 out the door. You couldn't pay more if you wanted to. Hurry, it's a done deal at Desert Nissan. But Monday, Altimas and Frontiers for $17,444 out the door are just plain done.
Tonight's Winter Games Update is brought to you by Saturn of West Sahara and Saturn of Henderson.
Not only is the United States enjoying their best Winter Games ever, they're also challenging Germany for the most medals. And earlier this afternoon, Team USA eliminated the Germans in men's hockey 5-0. They'll next meet Russia in Friday's semifinals. The winner of tonight's game between Canada and Finland will take on Belarus. Belarus pulled off one of the biggest upsets in history today, beating Sweden 4-3. Up on the mountain, American Jim Shea wins gold in the men's skeleton. It's like the luge, only a face forward on the sled. Tristan Gale also wins gold in the women's skeleton. Teammate Leanne Parsley takes the silver. And in women's speed skating, Germany dominates the 1,500-meter race. American Jennifer Rodriguez takes the bronze. And here's the medal board. Germany has 31, the United States up to 25, with competition wrapping up on Sunday. They're not going for gold in Reno, but state championships are on the line in the boys and girls basketball tournaments. We start with the boys. Green Valley taking on McQueen. The Gators looking to Mitch Platt. Platt misses, but Ron Dunlap is there, and he puts it back in. The favored Gators led throughout. They get a nice offensive thrust from Jonathan Osborne. He knocks in 16 as Green Valley knocks out McQueen 48-43. Jeremy Atwater scored 21 points, leading Las Vegas big over Centennial. They're in the third quarter with Cheyenne up 14 now over Desert Pines, and Hug and Bishop Gorman get going a bit later on. Now we shift to the girls' scores, and La Carson eliminates Las Vegas 59-45. Centennial blows out Valley. They run their record to 32-0. Bishop Gorman a big winner over Green Valley, and Douglas and Western get started in just a few minutes. The Running Rebels have three more games to get ready for their tournament. The winner of the Mountain West tourney earns a trip to the Big Dance. That's what they're thinking about. Chris Matthews was at practice today, and he'll have a report coming up in 20 minutes. The Mountain West Conference and the Liberty Bowl is a marriage that will stay together for at least three more years. The contract extension was announced today. The Mountain West champ will continue to play the champ of Conference USA. BYU and Louisville was the matchup in December. The new deal means that teams will try to take second place so they can come to Las Vegas instead of Memphis. That's not a joke. Just ask anyone who's been there. See you in 20 minutes.
Thanks, Dave. All
right. There's more news straight ahead on Channel 8 Eyewitness News Live at 6:30. A vaccine shortage could threaten the health of your kids. We'll show you what's being done.
A deputy district attorney wants to become Clark County's first female DA. We'll tell you who it is.
And in a special segment, an average family like yours and mine is struggling for survival after illness turns their lives upside down.
You're watching Channel 8 Eyewitness News at 6:30 with Paula Francis, Gary Waddell, Neighborhood Weather with Kevin Janison, and Sports with Dave McCann. Channel 8 Eyewitness News, the news leader.
Thanks for staying with us. Across the nation, there's a shortage of vaccine for children. That shortage is causing concerns among healthcare professionals.
The nationwide shortage of vaccinations is causing headaches at the Clark County Health District. District officials say they've spent the past year juggling a dwindling supply of adult vaccines. And they say while they do have enough children's vaccines for things like mumps and measles, they're concerned about the future.
The state, as I said, will be looking at a contingency plan as to how we implement if we do get that word that, in fact, we're not going to have vaccine.
The Centers for Disease Control in Atlanta are working on ways to correct the vaccine shortage.
A veteran criminal prosecutor has become the third member of the DA's staff to announce for district attorney. Abby Silver is in charge of the Special Victims Unit, which prosecutes domestic violence cases. But she says she's prosecuted everything from murder to DUI to child abuse. Silver says voters are ready for a female DA.
I believe Clark County voters are. I've been a prosecutor in the office for almost 12 years. The role of the district attorney is really not about gender. It's about putting criminals behind bars, and I've been doing that on a daily basis for the last 12 years. Certainly being chief of the unit and being designated that chief shows and how strong I am as a prosecutor. What I've done for the unit and putting away criminals shows that I can get the job done. So yes, they are ready for it.
Silver says if she's elected, she will create a major fraud unit to handle assorted scams that plague local residents. Two other deputy DAs are also seeking the top job, David Roger and Mike Davidson.
Anyone who's worked in health care for a while has seen families go from prosperous to impoverished because of an unexpected medical calamity.
And they also know it could happen to anyone. Andrea Bond joins us with an in-depth look at one family that's facing the battle of their lives.
Absolutely. Well, the story we have to share with you is that of the Everett family. They are like thousands of families across the valley, but you will not believe what they are going through. What's even more disturbing is how their situation could happen to any one of us.
Oh, everybody's excited. We're happy.
This photo brings back happy memories for Tim Everett, a reminder of the way things used to be. College sweethearts, he and his wife Peg were married in 1978. They have two beautiful girls, 12-year-old Tegan and 7-year-old Tara. The Everetts were living the perfect life in a picture-perfect neighborhood.
Just carefree days, you know.
But 2 years ago, this family's world was turned upside down.
I just thought it was another kidney stone. You know, the same symptoms, the same everything that you have for a kidney stone.
But the problem wasn't a kidney stone. Tim was diagnosed with kidney cancer, which quickly spread.
My kidney had a larger growth. My pancreas had a growth. My lung had a growth.
Tim's prognosis isn't good, but as sad as this story is, it gets worse, much worse.
My girls.
Lying next to Tim is his wife, Peg. This past August, she was diagnosed with colorectal cancer. She's now bedridden.
Very scared. I mean, what's going to happen?
Tim went on disability at the end of last year and gets $1,000 a week. It sounds like a lot, but with a mortgage and car payment, mounting medical costs, utilities, and two children to take care of, the Everetts are in real danger of losing everything.
Everything has piled up, and then now the doctor bill's on top of all that.
The Everetts never dreamt in a million years that they would both fall victim to cancer, both in their early 40s. They're in the prime of their lives and weren't prepared for something so devastating. Now they're faced with the question of what will happen to their kids if something happens to them.
There's no savings account left. There's no college tuition funds left.
The Everetts have gone through everything. Now Tim spends his time going online to find agencies that might help.
You name it, and I've called them and talked to them.
But in this post 9/11 world, they've been told there's little anyone can do. If the Everetts were homeless or indigent, or if their children were sick, there would be some help. But this couple, who was once living the American dream, it's now left wondering how that dream could disappear so quickly.
Obviously, this has all come as quite a shock to the Everetts. They are, however, very strong in their faith, so that has been of some comfort to them. But you can't help but sense the desperation these people are facing.
It's terrible. Just how badly are the bills piling up?
Well, I had a chance to talk to the Everetts about that. The mortgage payment is $1,600. Outstanding medical bills, $4,000. You add utilities on top of that. Car payments, the credit cards, they've really got a lot to deal with. As we mentioned, they've tried to get help, haven't been able to. We tried to find out why that is, and we will have more on that part of the story.
Okay, in just a minute.
Okay, that's coming up. Stay with us for Eyewitness News, live at 6:30.
They were in the prime of their lives, living the American dream. Then the unthinkable happened. Reporter Andrea Bond has the story of a Valley couple facing a challenge that could happen to any of us. The story tonight at 6:30 on Channel 8 Eyewitness News, the news leader.
It's the grand opening of Cal's Boat and RV, the biggest boat and RV superstore in the state. We're located at Russell Road and the US 95 Freeway. During this sale, you can save on the entire line of Four Winds and Chaparral deck boats, runabouts, Cuddies and cruisers, Sierra, Salem and Jayco toy haulers, travel trailers and fifth wheels, even Arctic Cat ATVs are on sale. Make Cal's your one-stop recreation destination for quality boats and RVs.
Come and see my grandpa's big toy store.
Cal's Boat and RV.
This President's Day, Walker Furniture gives you financial freedom. Get everything you want for your home and pay no interest for 2 full years. Shop the Valley's best selection of living rooms, bedrooms, dinettes at prices guaranteed to beat the competition.
The prices are fabulous.
We saved half of what other people were charging. Yes.
Join us for free hot dogs and soda as we celebrate President's Day with incredible savings throughout the store. Plus, get free financing until 2004. Hurry in today. It all ends Sunday. It's gotta be Walker. Always less.
It's our President's Holiday Sale at Carpinteria, where you'll get historic savings store-wide. Buy with no money down, no payment, and no interest for 1 year. DuPont Stainmaster Carpet is on sale, complete with pad installation and our total satisfaction guarantee. Stainmaster Carpets for beauty that lasts. Holiday savings on vinyl, ceramic, laminate, and hardwood. All with no money down, no payment, and no interest for 1 year. The President's Holiday Sale at Carpinteria. Through Monday, hurry.
It's Jackets for Jackpots, February 4th through 28th at Sam's Town Hotel and Gambling Hall. Hit a select jackpot and win a premium Sam's Town jacket. Or collect 10,000 points on your Prime Rewards card and we'll give you the jacket and you'll keep the points.
Simply the best!
It's Jackets for Jackpots at Sam's Town Hotel and Gambling Hall. Complete rules and details at the Prime Rewards Center.
Simply the best!
Couples married just a few months getting divorced.
It took longer to get divorced and we were together the entire relationship.
How do they know it's all wrong already? Watch the next Inside Edition.
Tonight at 7:30 on Channel 8.
Cancer is something no family ever wants to face, but imagine facing it twice and not finding the help you need.
That's exactly what one local family is struggling with. Channel 8 Eyewitness News reporter Andrea Bond joins us with more on her story. Andrea.
Well, before the break, we told you about the incredible challenges the Everett family is facing. But what's even more unbelievable is how little help is out there for them. We tried to find out why.
This is a picture of Tim and Peg Everett before the cancer hit. This is them today. In the course of 2 years, Tim was diagnosed with stage 4 kidney cancer, and Peg is now bedridden with colorectal cancer. The outlook is grim.
We could have a miraculous healing, you know, and we could be walking around tomorrow and nothing be wrong with us again. But the reality is that probably won't happen.
Facing the worst, the Everetts have tried to manage. But they're not only battling an illness, they're also fighting to pay their mortgage, a car payment, utilities, medical expenses, and provide for their two girls. The family savings have been completely depleted. They've even turned to charities for help.
You know, we've got all these great organizations out there that want to help, but they have so many rules and restrictions on how they help.
I have to say, we can't help everybody. There's people that are getting turned away, you bet.
Among them, the Everetts. They've been turned away by the United Way and many other organizations. Because they own a home and a car, no one has been able to provide financial help. The Everetts have been told in order to get that help, they'll have to make, quote, lifestyle changes.
It is the front end, if you will, of what happens to many people who ultimately become homeless.
In a situation like this, charities like the United Way want to lend a helping hand, but they say since the devastating effects of September 11th, the resources just aren't there. The Everetts aren't the only people they've had to turn away.
The Everetts are going through an incredible time right now. I can't even imagine what the challenges that they are facing, and we have hundreds and hundreds of other families with stories very similar.
And so sadly, the Everetts are in real danger of losing everything, a reality that's become hard to accept.
Yeah, it's very frustrating. I mean, it's just, I can't say how frustrating it is.
For now, the Everetts can do little more than pray and take some comfort in knowing that even if the system can't help them, they still have each other.
Well, the United Way says since September 11th, they've been getting about 200 calls a day, so you can imagine how great and widespread the need is in our community. At the same time, the United Way is looking at cutting many of the programs they fund by up to 30%, so it really is a very scary time for anyone out there trying to get assistance.
If agencies can't help, are they getting any help from anywhere?
Luckily, they are getting some help. Their church has been good to them. They have a great neighborhood, so neighbors have come forward. There's some talk that Walker Furniture might be able to donate some furniture, but what they really need right now is money. We should mention the family has set up a trust fund, so if you would like to help, you can log on to our website to get details. That's at KLASTV.com.
Scary how it really could happen to anyone.
Any one of us.
Yeah, serious medical problem and things sort of...
You never know what will happen.
Yeah. Let's hope we made a difference for them.
Thank you.
Thanks, Andrea.
Kevin will be back with the weather.
Hi, I'm John Elway for Desert Nissan. Nobody beats our prices.
It's a done deal. The all-new Desert Nissan Altima or Frontier. Now $17,444 out the door. Through Saturday, Desert Nissan has set the price on the 2002 Altima or Frontier Crew Cab XE at just $17,444 out the door. You couldn't pay more if you wanted to. Hurry, it's a done deal at Desert Nissan. But Monday, Altimas and Frontiers for $17,444 out the door are just plain done.
Ashley Furniture Home Store presents Free February. For the remainder of the month of February, buy any five-piece living room and get a pair of lamps free.
Free!
Buy any complete bedroom and get a second nightstand free. Buy any five-piece dining room and get another side chair free. Plus, free financing until February 2003. For factory direct prices, plus free furniture and free financing for one full year. Hurry in today. This event ends the 28th at 7 p.m. You're gonna love Free February.
Ashley Furniture Home Store.
Used car buyers, used truck buyers, SUV buyers, Nevada Dodge, 1 week only. They're guaranteeing you $3,000 minimum for any trade-in. And exclusive of that, $3,000 now cash or trade-in. You can buy this 2001 model Ram 1500 truck, $8,988. Or a 1999 Mazda 626, $7,988. Nevada Dodge, perhaps the largest used car inventory in Las Vegas. But the deadline's Monday night. Nevada Dodge.
Families like these families need your help. You can make a difference by donating your car, boat, or RV. Your donation is tax deductible, and Volunteers of America will pick it up and handle all the paperwork. Volunteers of America serves the emotional, physical, and spiritual needs of over 1.5 million people a year. Donate your car, get a tax deduction. Call now, 450-2000. That's 450-2000.
It's unbelievable. It's explosive. It's a just-for-beat super sale with super hot values that are just right for you. Now, Nike and New Balance, just $49.99. Reebok V-Lens Skechers, just $39.99. And Reebok, just $29.99. Plus, lots of hot values for the kids. All this and hundreds of new arrivals from the best brands. Hey, why pay more? Just-for-beat is just right for you.
Altair at Eagle Rock. Act now during our final phase and you can afford your own luxury home.
Welcome back to Darnell Elementary. And Dylan, what does your dad do?
He hauls oil, he paves roads, and he demolishes buildings.
And he does some good work in the community. And please thank him very much, because if it wasn't for Jeff Rayner and the Rayner family, we wouldn't have this weather station here, would we?
Nope.
He did a good job. So please thank him very much. We're here with just a few folks left from Darnell Elementary, including some very large fifth graders. Wow. Let's begin with real-time neighborhood weather at the weather station, our newest member of the network from right here at Darnell Elementary near Fort Apache and Ann Road. It's down to 56 degrees across town near Eastern and the St. Rose Parkway. The temperature is at 60 degrees. We'll keep on moving to Jones and Smoke Ranch. They are at 58. And one more stop will take us to Bonanza and Pecos, where the temperature is 59 degrees. Not much wind there. Current temperatures in neighborhood neighborhoods across town range anywhere from the upper 50s to low to mid 60s, depending on your neck of the cactus. It's 44 on the mountain, and it's 62 out at the Lake Mead Marina. On the satellite picture, high pressure is building in. Look at those clouds in the Pacific moving almost due north. As a result, we are not going to see much in the way of cloud cover, but we are going to see much in the way of mild temperatures over the next few days. Clear in 45 tonight. A little breeze picks up after midnight, but it shouldn't get any stronger than 15 miles per hour. It'll be with us tomorrow, too. But how about this? A high of 72 with some neighborhoods in the upper 70s tomorrow. And a look ahead at your 7-day forecast. Could set a record high on Saturday when we expect the mercury to soar to 70. And then a little cooler late in the weekend and early next week. It's time now for a public service here. Annie, what kind of allowance do you get?
$3.
Is that a week?
A day, sometimes.
What? Where does your mom work?
Channel 8.
She makes millions, doesn't she?
I don't know. She won't tell me. She says it's private.
You know what? When you go home, you say it's $10 a day or I'm walking, okay?
Okay.
All right, good job. See if we helped Annie out. Thank you guys all very much. Gary and Paula from our new weather station, we'll send it back to you.
Oh, you're in trouble, Kevin.
I'll hear about that.
Thanks, Kevin.
Dave McCann is here. Some good golf today. Unfortunately, the number one guy wasn't playing it.
You have to wonder if he's peaked. He's off to a very rotten start as Tiger Woods lost it. He's starting to play like everybody else on the tour. The running Rebels are in the gym doing just that, a lot of running. UNLV's recent success has the team thinking about the postseason. And we'll call it bay hopping. John Gruden goes from Oakland to Tampa, and he couldn't be happier. Sports is next here on Channel 8.
Hollywood's rich kid, Madonna's Rocco, Jennifer Connelly's son, and how some stars spoil their children. Then limo drivers to the stars, bad tippers, who sits on the floor, and the security. Plus Kelly Ripa, next ET.
Tonight at 7 on Channel 8.
All my Toyotas.
I can't believe they got me in one of these Toyota soap opera commercials. If I weren't getting such a good deal on a truck, I'd be strangling my agent.
Get incredible factory-to-dealer savings on the powerful iForce V8 Tundra. You'll also find great deals on the rugged Tacoma. Toyota trucks are so rugged, even bad acting can't hurt them.
Is he talking about me? Maybe I should be a cowboy.
See your Toyota dealer now for truly dramatic savings.
It's been called extraordinary. It's been called unreal. And now it's even more irresistible. Mystère by Cirque du Soleil. Locals purchase two tickets and receive premium seating, a complimentary dinner at Kahunaville, and if you desire, a deluxe room for an additional $49. Locals, tonight is your night. Call now.
I can't eat anymore.
That turkey was so tender.
Yeah, I've got to wish my belly. Hey, someone pushed me away from this table.
Direct from the Olympic Games, Michelle Kwan, Sarah Hughes, Irina Slutskaya, Todd Eldridge, Elvis Stoiko, Timothy Gable, Evgeny Plashenko, Sasha Cohen, and Michael Weiss, plus Rudy Galindo, Philippe Candeloro, and many more Olympic and world champions in John Hancock Champions on Ice 2002 Olympic Tour.
Coming Saturday, August 3rd to the MGM Grand Garden. Tickets go on sale this Monday.
Experience the Olympic magic.
Couples married just a few months getting divorced.
It took longer to get divorced, and we were together the entire relationship.
How do they know it's all wrong already? Watch the next Inside Edition.
Tonight at 7:30 on Channel 8.
Running Rebels close out their regular season with three straight home games. They also host the Mountain West Tournament. They're a good team at home, and as Chris Matthews reports, that's why they're excited about the days ahead.
With such parity in the conference, UNLV's countdown is on.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
For UNLV, that's their magic number. 3 home wins, 3 tourney wins, and the Rebels are going dancing.
Yeah, we can do it.
You know, we
had a good chance to go this time.
I think we got a very good chance.
You know, it's all up to us to win. It's going to be a lot of fun this next month.
This is a team that's won 7 of 9. They get a close on their home court. No wonder they're excited.
Can't even describe the words. I can't. It gets me tongue twisted. I was just imagining about it, what's going to happen.
If you want to share Pearson's excitement, you're not alone.
Here lately, we've been playing very well at home, so I think we got a chance to do it, and we can do it, and hopefully we get there.
Can this team win 6 in a row?
Yeah, we can. We can also lose 6 in a row, so we've got to come out and play hard, you know, get the fans behind us, and hopefully have a good tournament run, and hopefully we'll get in the dance.
It don't get no sweeter than that. A lot of other teams are biased to that because we're playing it at home, but, you know, we have the best arena, we have the best city, so, you know, just come and play ball, and we're going to come and play ball and make the best player win.
Hey, you want to dream a little more? 6 home wins, 6 on the road, and UNLV would be crowd champions. Chris Matthews, Channel 8 Eyewitness Sports.
Thank you, Chris. Up next for the Rebels is Saturday night showdown with San Diego State. Tip times at 7:30. You can see the game live on our cable channel, Las Vegas One. The biggest surprise in the NFL's offseasons with the Raiders and Buccaneers, Oakland allowed their head coach to move to Tampa Bay in return for draft picks and a whole lot of money. Today, John Gruden was introduced as the Bucs' new man.
All I can guarantee is a lot of hard work and effort in trying to put the Tampa Bay Buccaneers into championship form.
Well, how about this for a surprise? Australian Peter O'Malley makes this putt to beat Tiger Woods in the first round of the World Match Play Championship in Carlsbad. Tiger was the top seed. O'Malley was the bottom seed at number 64. That would be right up there with an upset. We'll call it that.
Yes. So,
thanks, Dave.
You're welcome.
We'll be right back.
Neighborhood Weather is brought to you by Lamplight Neighborhoods and your hometown neighborhood builder, Karina Holmes.
Start spreading the news about the 2002s and all the big new markdowns at Courtesy Olds, including 2002 Kias from only $129 a month, 2002 Mazdas from just $159 a month, and up to $7,000 off new Isuzu SUVs. Plus, get up to 60% off Nevada's largest selection of used vehicles right now, right here at Courtesy Olds, 5800 West Sahara, one block east of Jones, where everybody drives.
The disc, they're coming your way.
Excellent. Describe the vehicle.
They're driving, it's a silverish, bluish.
It's a bluish what?
Secret weapon? Escape pod? The new Toyota Matrix. That's something else.
There's nothing like getting something free. Take your choice of either of these beautiful sofas. How much? $700, $800? No, we've got them in stock for an incredible $599. And during Sofa Connection free days, the matching love seat is absolutely free. Add no down payment, no payment, and no interest till 2003. It's a bargain you can't afford to miss. Sofa and matching love seat, only $599. Financing like it's free till 2003. Free days going on now, only at Sofa Connection.
Tobin Dodge is doing the unthinkable. We're giving away 500 new cars and trucks at invoice, which means you pay what we pay. Plus, get 0% financing, up to $10,000 off select models, and a free 7-year, 100,000-mile warranty. This week only at Tobin Dodge. 500 new cars and trucks at invoice. No gimmicks, no games, just flat dealer invoice. Only at the Tobin Dodge Superstore. Number one in Nevada for a reason, in the Valley Auto Mall.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Cocked your head to the side and said I'm angry. Yeah, keep forgiving me, but it'll still be 2 days till I say I'm sorry. Gonna make a break and take a pick. I like a sink and ink and shake. I like vanilla. It's the finest.
Hey, there's your brother.
That's not them.
The 2002 Mitsubishi Lancer. Right now, pay zero down, zero interest, and zero payments till 2003.
That's it for Eyewitness News live at 6.
We hope you'll join us at 11.
Closed captioning of this newscast is brought to you by Valley Hospital Medical Center, a member of the Valley Health System.